Did you know that lack of sleep can increase your risk of many serious health conditions, including early death? Yikes! We're sure by now you're aware of the importance of getting a good night's rest. Being tired can really put a damper on your productivity and just make you feel kind of crummy. When we go to sleep, we don't really know what's going on inside our bodies or minds, but it turns out there's a lot happening. Today, here at Bestie, we're gonna take a peek behind the curtain and uncover what your body does while you're under the covers. Before we start, don't sleep on hitting that subscribe button and ringing the notification bell too. Doesn't matter if you're a night owl or an early bird, getting a proper night's sleep can really make a difference in how we feel the next day. There are few things more annoying than being woken up from a wonderful deep sleep by some loud neighbors or someone calling at an ungodly hour. Some people claim that they can even function pretty well on only a few hours of sleep at night, but it turns out your body needs this time to recharge and sort of reset from the previous day. Sleep isn't something that happens quickly, it sort of happens in stages, and there's actually a lot that goes on once you close your eyes. You may have heard the term REM sleep before. This stands for rapid eye movement and is just one example of the stages of sleep we're gonna get to in a moment. You actually will go through most of these stages of sleep 3 to 5 times every night, which is why it's known as a sleep cycle, since you cycle through these phases many times. Let's start from the beginning though. The first stage of sleep is the same stage we find ourselves in when someone wants to show you their vacation photos, or you're in a really boring meeting, the dozing off phase. The dozing off phase is that phase when someone says, "Oh, you were asleep." And your response is likely, "No, I wasn't." You're not alone in saying this. In fact, 80% of people will say they weren't sleeping if woken up suddenly from this dozing off stage. This stage is more your brain prepping for sleep than actual sleep itself. And many researchers continue to argue if this stage is actually sleep at all. In this stage, your brain is still pretty active and it will be easy to wake someone up. As you progress into deeper stages, your brain kind of disconnects from the outside world and it becomes harder to wake from. But we'll get to the deep sleep phase in a moment. Stage 1 is considered non-REM sleep, and it's when your brain starts to file away and process what happened during the day. This is also when your brain will create long-term memories. Your brain will also release a bunch of hormones while you're sleeping. And in stage 1, melatonin will be flooded into your system, causing you to feel sleepy. From there, we progress to stage 2. Researchers seem to agree that stage 2 can officially be classified as sleep. We're not quite into REM sleep yet, but we're getting closer. This part of the sleep cycle is when your brain starts to calm down and your breathing gradually slows. Your body temperature will also start to drop. You can still be woken up from this stage pretty easily until about 90 minutes or so have passed when you'll enter REM sleep. During stage 2, you'll start to disconnect from your surroundings as the brain relaxes, as well as your nervous system. Have you ever heard of the fight or flight response? This is your sympathetic nervous system telling you how to react to certain situations and is always on watch during the day. When you sleep, your sympathetic nervous system finally gets a chance to relax. And studies tell us that this is one very important part of sleep and how it relates to our overall health. Giving your nervous system some time off can actually help combat the negative health effects sleep deprivation can cause, like high blood pressure and heart disease. Speaking of relaxing, during sleep, your body's level of cortisol will drop as well. This hormone is often called the stress hormone and is another important part of the restorative process. Taking a natural break from stress? Sign us up! These cortisol hormone levels will rise once again before you wake up, which also wakes your stomach and can help you feel perky in the morning. Or sort of perky, if you're not really a morning person. Next, we're on to what some research calls stage 3 and 4. Where we're into deep sleep now, but not exactly REM sleep just yet. These deep sleep stages are the ones that really matter, the ones that do the heavy lifting when it comes to repairing your body and restoring your mind. When you're exhausted, this is the kind of sleep you're craving. No amount of coffee will fix what this kind of sleep can. Around this point is where your body will release another hormone from your pituitary gland. It's actually a growth hormone, and this is the one that helps repair your body or will help your body grow where needed. This deep sleep restorative cycle is where your blood pressure and heart rate will slow as well before the next stage. Up next, the famous REM sleep. Welcome to dreamland. 90 minutes or so into your sleep cycle, you're likely to slip into REM sleep. Not all dreams happen in this phase, as sleep is generally tailored to each individual. REM sleep is the phase that ramps up your brain once again and is almost like being awake. Except you're not. Rapid eye movement sleep gets its name because, quite literally, your eyes are darting around in rapid movements. Kind of makes sense, right? This is also where your body will become paralyzed, and you're likely to experience your most vivid dreams here. Some researchers think that the reason we become paralyzed in this stage is so we won't act out our dreams, which probably saves us a lot of embarrassment, especially when you're acting out that big moment of nailing that guitar solo in front of thousands of adoring fans. You wouldn't want to be acting that out on your front lawn at 2 in the morning, right? REM sleep will start off as a pretty short stage, but as you keep cycling through the sleep stages, it'll increase and can last for a full 30 minutes at times. This is also the stage when your breathing will get faster, your body temperature lowers, and your blood pressure will go back to normal. This is also the phase when your brain is very active, which is why your dreams are so bizarre sometimes. Some research also suggests REM sleep is when your brain dumps out all that useless information that you've probably accumulated over the day. If you don't get to the REM sleep cycle or are sleep deprived, then your brain won't get a chance to sift through all that information and store the things that you need to keep and get rid of the stuff you don't. Once you've completed this REM cycle, your body starts the process over again until you're ready to wake up. Getting a good night's sleep helps you think clearly, boosts your immune system so you don't get sick, and can help decrease your risk of many health issues like diabetes, obesity, cancer, and heart complications. The science shows us that you should aim to get anywhere from 7 to 8 hours of sleep a night to get all the benefits that restful sleep can provide. Try making your bedroom a place of tranquility and calm that you'll enjoy sleeping in. Also, making sleep a priority is part of a healthy lifestyle and can really benefit you in the long run. Much more than just beauty sleep, if you ask us. How many hours of sleep do you usually get at night? Are you a night owl or an early bird? Why not let us know any tricks you have to getting a good night's sleep in the comments section below. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of bestie are we if we don't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.